A show on a bus? That's right. Find out Saturday following Star Trek only on Channel 3.
Almost live and recorded with ENG Studio 50. You're in Grand Alley on a Grata bus with the one and only Gregory Struss. I'm Ev Strong from Music Review, inviting you to stay tuned for the next 30 minutes because you'll hang out with me. Take a look at what happened when Greg and the other Greg crashed a popular morning show in Grand Rapids. Bond with the Grand Rapids Hoops basketball players Jeff, Justin, and Antonio. Plus, Music Review presents the acoustic sounds of Bob Rowe and Rendell Wall. And now, here's the only host who can play fair, but not pay his fare, Gregory Struss.
We are on a bus, a Grata bus, and Ev is sitting way in the corner over here because you're like, I'm not getting in on this thing. You are all by yourself. Let's talk about tonight's show. We have a look at our trip to WLAV. We crashed in on the Tony Gates' morning show and tried to find some answers. It was like a more of a guerrilla kind of interview. Wasn't it 60 Minutes kind of thing? We also are going to bond with a couple of the Hoops basketball players. Of course, we're on the show, on the bus, right now, the Hoops bus. We have Justin Jennings, Antonio Lang, and Jeff Caple, all from the Grand Rapids Hoops. What else do we have? We also have a look at... who? Oh, Bob Rowe, and who is his partner here? His partner,
Rendell Wall.
His father had a show on Channel 3 for something for like 30 years. Went off the air in 80.
Kind of
like
here's just 30 minutes.
Like we're going to do right now. So it's a show on a bus. Here's Ev from Music Review to tell you how you can write in and, you know, become a member of our studio audience. So take it away, Ev.
Here's an opportunity to contact West Michigan's most insane half hour of weekly television by logging on to our homepage on the World Wide Web at www.gawgs.brockhouse.com. You take a look at who will be appearing on upcoming showgrams, plus ascertain how you can attend a taping of our magnificent showgram and win tickets to shows at the Orbit Room and other Ticketmaster concerts at www.gawgs.brockhouse.com. Or try contact us the old-fashioned way by faxing us at area code 616-844-3353. Either way, we want to bond with you. Now, back to more of the only show ever done on a Grata bus on Grand Alley with Greg Struss.
And we are back on the Grand Rapids Woo! Hoops Grata bus. Tell me what Grata stands for, Ev.
Grand Rapids Area Transport Authority.
Transit.
Well, they need transport.
Is this nuts or what?
This is fun.
It's like everybody's idea.
Not for me, but it is fun.
I think we're going to start delivering mail after today's show. Here are some interesting tidbits about Grata. They are the transportation for Grand Rapids buses.
Establish it.
Number of buses, that's correct, 80. There are 80 buses. We are on the Hoops Grata bus. The outside of this bus is shrink-wrapped with images of kids from area schools, and I believe there's a couple players out here as well, right?
Players.
Okay.
Correct, sir. You are correct, sir.
And what?
And Hoopy.
That's right. Okay. There's 80 buses, including this one. Annual tires that go through use are 200. Annual miles driven. Is this amazing? 2.3 million. Is this all of them? I mean, with all the buses? So combined, 2.3 million miles. There's 92 drivers. Our driver tonight is Jim Archie.
Way to go, Jim! Woo!
15 mechanics, 40 staff members, carries 3.3 million passengers annually. And that's just following a Hoops game, isn't it? Okay. And last but not least, in this exciting bit of information, there's 2,600 passenger stops, including shelters.
For unemployed TV hosts
after tonight. They're dropping me off after this. Okay. We had the chance to go to LAV. Tony Gates is the morning show host over there. He's also the operations manager of K KLQ. We have been working with the head honcho. And you still work there, kind of.
I'm on hiatus.
You're on hiatus right now. Okay.
I don't want to burn any bridges.
You don't want to burn too many bridges. Well, we decided, since Tony wasn't returning any of our phone calls, that another great idea that Greg had, we decided to go and crash Tony Gates' morning show at LAV in an attempt to ask him some questions on why, number one, he doesn't return phone calls, and to see why KLQ isn't working with us right now. So go ahead, roll that tape, and here it is. We've decided to walk in on Tony Gates' morning show and ask him a few questions. I thought for sure there was going to be a security guard waiting for us. Now, from what I understand, I know KLQ is on the 10th floor. We're going to find out if LAV is on the 9th floor. You know anything about the People's Building?
No.
No. Never been here. Okay. Have you ever been on an elevator with a camera before? I haven't.
No.
See, we're making news here. We're making...
It's good TV.
It's good TV. This is good TV because it involves drama, acting, all that good stuff. Candor, the unexpected. Probably see it on a rerun of the X-Files. Okay, and let's take a look here. All right. Okay, as far as we know, this is LAV, but it's locked. So we need to figure out where we're going to be able to go to find him. KLQ, which is upstairs. Let's see if we can get out of here. Nope. Door locks. Okay. Do we make it through this or not today? I just want you to know. Clues for the show. Boy, and there's not a receptionist present. Now, this is where we really need to consult an attorney. Hi, how are you doing?
Good, how are you doing?
Good. I was wondering, is there any way you can let us in to talk with Tony Gates?
As far as me,
yeah.
I don't have that power, but I can find out for you.
Could you?
Yeah.
Thank you. And say, yeah, some morons out here with a camera. We think so. Word may have trickled down. Have you heard of our television show, Grand Alley? Have you heard of our show?
Sure.
We're here to find out why we're not no longer able to work with you.
Oh no.
Tony said that Tony told everyone at KLQ, he's like, you guys can't make appearances on his show anymore. What's your name? Okay. Have you heard of our show, Grand Alley?
Mm-hmm.
Do you know why Tony's not letting anyone come on anymore? By chance?
No idea. I work for BBL, so.
Oh, you're the old sports channel.
Mm-hmm.
So you haven't heard anything in the house that, you know, you guys can't do our show anymore?
No, okay. I haven't heard anything about it.
Okay, just was wondering. Right. He is on the air right now. I can't believe we're down here. Have you heard of our show?
Shut it off if you would, please.
Why do you have to ask us to leave? Are you mute?
No.
Are you giving me the West Michigan stare?
I'm as mute as you are rude.
Rude?
Sure.
How is this rude?
Because we asked you to leave.
Okay, now you're just asking me to leave. We wanted to ask Tony why KLQ can't be involved in our show anymore.
All I know is I have to ask you gentlemen to leave. Is that so hard to understand?
I thought you were bright news guys. Bright news guys?
Sure. You managed to get your way in here.
Well, we just wanted to talk with him, that's all.
Understand. You may have an appointment?
I would call, but he doesn't return phone calls.
You don't have an appointment, then.
Okay, which means what?
Which means you have to leave.
Okay, will you see us to the door, then?
Sure.
Okay, let's go.
Let's get the camera turned around.
Okay.
Goes that way. Thank you, John.
You don't have to be rude. Get out of the bush.
97 LAV FM. Well, that was a look.
Woo!
As professional as ever, too, don't you think? Remember, it's
and
public
stuff.
Transportation, not public entertainment. We're on Grotta, and we'll be back right after this.
Check 14 1-4.
Where you at? We can both listen both.
Yeah.
You want both?
Yeah.
Yeah. Both. Yeah.
Oh, really?
We
okay.
Hello.
Pretty much straightened out.
Yeah, we gotta roll.
Okay. What do you? Let's
do
go through it.
Savannah, they're gonna play through some.
I've already briefed.
Daisy, do you have any outstanding bizarre talents? Anything?
I don't think anything
that you brought to Scott.
Nothing.
All right.
Can you give me some time? Yes. Can you come up?
Okay, this is it. Let's go.
Let's just wing it.
Let's wing it.
John, I need to know how long the second song is for the band. Okay. Over?
If anyone does impressions, that's always a good thing.
Actually, the show goes on. We tape it straight through. It's live on tape. Hi, Kelly. How are you? This is Darren's girlfriend, Kelly, who's never introduced herself.
Hi.
How do you tie these things?
Except that the shot we take of her is so fast that... Okay, yeah, start about there and then go in. Yeah. And fewer.
Now, here's the only host who thinks Burger Chef's gonna make a comeback, Gregory Struss!
Oops. Bus, thank you very much.
We're
all here. And Bob Rowe and Rendell Wall are here. Now, an interesting bit of trivia here. Rendell's father hosted a show right here on Channel 3 for how long? How many years was it?
34 years.
So it was from what, the 50s?
Yeah, in the early 50s to the early 80s. Yeah.
What kind of show was it?
Well, it was a country show, but we had a lot of entertainment on there over the years. Many big stars were on there.
So now you get to like pass the torch and come
on
the show.
Yeah, I'm kind of Bob's roadie now. I follow him around and make sure he gets from place to place there.
I don't know if I go along with that or not.
And also, Bob has a special coming up on PBS. You've also been featured on TNN. Tell us a little bit about the special coming up on GVU.
The special is going to be featuring myself and Rendell and some of our artists going around to do shows for senior citizens, which is something that I founded approximately 10 years ago, and it's a really cool thing. And
you're on the cover of Mature Years.
Yes. Does that mean I'm mature now or just working
on it? I don't know. And you also have a disc out? Tell us about that.
Got my disc out. That's portraits. That's a compilation of a lot of the traditional songs, like As Time Goes By. Got a new Christmas disc out at all the stores and several others.
Do you have a song coming out in honor of a Hoops Bus
song? I think Alberta, Come Back Home.
Okay, yeah. Here they are. Let's go. Let's
Alberta, hear. Alberta. Alberta, Alberta, where you've been so long. I've been thinking of you, baby, how you done me wrong. Alberta, Alberta, where you sleep last night. I'm a Grotta, Alberta, Alberta.
Alberta, where you've been so long. I've been thinking of you, baby, how you done me wrong. I've been missing you, baby, how you done me wrong.
Yeah.
Yes.
Bob and Wendell, and we'll be back with more fun on the Grotta Bus. Stay with us.
Conversation so strong.
Yeah, we wanna play. I said, now, yeah, we wanna play. Yeah, we wanna play. I said, now, we wanna play.
I love you more than I can say. I'll love you twice as much tomorrow. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Love you more than I can
when
say.
When it comes to subs, Blimpy founder Tony Kanza has strong feelings. That's why, unlike some other sub places, Blimpy uses choice meats, real dairy cheese, and fresh baked bread.
I love
Tony Kanza, a man who loves his subs.
Blimpy, it's a beautiful thing.
Meatball sub combo meal, $3.49 at Blimpy.
If you love lava lamps, leather, or great clothing, come to Purple East on Fulton near Division in beautiful downtown GR. Attend a taping of Grand Alley with Gregory Struss and receive 20% off on your next visit to Purple East.
It's West Michigan's first local TV talk entertainment showgram. Don't miss Grand Alley with Gregory Struss Saturday nights at 12:30 on Channel 3.
Grand Rapids Hoops Bus, and we're going to let you guys introduce yourselves here.
I'm Jeff Caple.
Jeff Caple.
Antonio Lang.
Antonio Lang.
Justin Jennings.
And Justin Jennings, all from the Hoops. You guys have just finished practice today, huh? What's that like? I mean, you walk out and all of a sudden you got to do an interview.
We kind of had a short practice today because we've been on the road for the last 3 or 4 days, actually riding a bus to Fort Wayne, Indiana and Rockford, Illinois. And we got back yesterday about 5 o'clock in the morning. We had a game at 6, so it's been tough.
So do you find it hard to travel and then get back onto the court the day after?
Yeah, well, it's tough. Here it's a little bit different here because we spent 4 hours on a bus, you know, and then we had to come back and then play, you know. And that's the travel, I think, is the toughest thing in this league.
Is it ever a Grotta bus or the Hoops bus?
No, not. The good thing we're on a big bus, so we're not on a little van. So
John Christensen, one of our camera people, was saying, you know what, you guys played for, Antonio played for Duke, and Jeff played for Duke University. What was that like? And then all of a sudden, now you're in Grand Rapids.
It was cool playing for Duke. We got a chance to play for Coach K, one of the best coaches probably in the history of basketball, and got a chance to play in front of some of the best fans. The atmosphere in the ACC, I think, is second to none. North Carolina is a basketball state. That's where I'm originally from, and to play basketball there, that's what a lot of people there live for, is ACC basketball. Tony and I also got a chance to get a first-class education there, and so, you know, Duke was a great experience. Grand Rapids is something that's completely different to CBA in that, it's a professional league, and, you know, the brand of basketball is different, and, you know, just the environment is different. You know, you come from, you know, playing in front of, 9,000 sellout crowd every night. And, you know, here, you know, our fans here in Grand Rapids are great, but sometimes we go on the road and, you know, there are not many people. And so, you know, it's different in that way, but, you know, it's definitely a learning experience.
Now, one of the things I always find that when you're watching ESPN, clicking through the stations, it's like sports people are always talking about the same thing. And as the staff and I were talking about doing the interview, we're like, let's not talk about basketball because you guys are always talking about this. Well, what did you think about last night's game? How do you think you can make it better? One of the positive things, I guess, is that you're very involved in the community. The Hoops bus. Let's talk about the bus we are on right now. Do you want to discuss the bus with the rap, the kids?
Well, the Hoops Loop came about last year. We had a lot of businesses that donated tickets, and the inner city kids and kids around the community, they had no way of getting to the game. So the bus came about from the Hoops as an organization trying to develop community involvement and get kids at the game and be able to pick them up, and not only pick them up, but to take them back home, you know, after the game is over with.
So somebody was telling me that you guys went to area schools and said, if you don't fight, if we get, no, right, is this correct? If you don't fight for several months or for a month or something, you treat them to a game, you pick them up and take them to the game.
That's basically some of our incentives for, or criteria for having kids come to the game is perfect attendance and, you know, improving your grades. We don't only want to have kids who have good grades all the time, but we won't have kids who may have been bad before and now they're improving and they have some sort of incentive, you know, to get better.
So what does that feel like, kind of being a mentor now to some of these kids?
Well, I think it's very important because when I was younger, I had someone I had to look up to, and I was fortunate to have my mother and father right there. A lot of these kids, unfortunately, don't have that support group around them. So I think it's very important that we really get involved and help these kids.
And what are some of the ways you're going to be helping them come holiday?
You know, just in whatever way. You know, getting out and, you know, showing them, showing them love, showing them support, you know, showing that we care about them as people. And, you know, giving them incentives to come to the games. And, you know, hopefully when they come, you know, give them a good time, you know, having autograph sessions. We have 10 minutes after each game. You know, we sign autographs and, you know, at times we give away shirts to, you know, the lucky fan and, you know, shoes and things like that. And, you know, just show them, you know, that we care. You know, we're not just here, you know, just solely to play basketball, but, you know, also to give back to the community because, you know, I mean, let's face it, without fans, there wouldn't be any professional basketball leagues, and that's what it's for.
What's up next? Now, you guys got some games coming up in December. You hitting the road again?
Yeah, we hit the road. I looked at the schedule and play like four games in 5 days, and all of them are on the road. So just have to be prepared for it. You know, we need to start winning some games too. You know, we've lost, I think, like three in a row, close games, you know, we should have won. But that's something that we're gonna have to improve on, and I think we will. You know, the season's still young. We just, what, I think 6 games into the season, so we'll be all right.
And appreciate you guys coming out and riding on this bumpy ride, and wish you the best of luck as you continue. You guys working hard. I came to your first game this season. It was the first Hoops game I ever came to. It was kind of exciting, and we appreciate you coming out. We have Justin, Antonio, and Jeff, and we'll be back in just a moment. Stay with us. A very special thanks to all the great people at Grotta for their assistance and patience with the production of tonight's showgram, especially our driver, Jim Archie. Grotta working together to meet Grand Rapids commuting needs for today and the next millennium.
It's West Michigan's first local TV talk entertainment showgram. Don't miss Grand Alley with Gregory Struss Saturday nights at 12:30 on Channel 3.
Here's your ticket to the most cosmic experience here in West Michigan, the Orbit Room. Join us every Wednesday for A2X Live on KLQ with alternative DJ T-Rex. Friday nights live on 104.5 WSNX with Shannon the Spin Dog. Saturdays disco and retro with Glenn the Spin Cat on the all-new I-96. And here's what's coming up. For more information, contact 942-1328.
And here's to you, Mrs. Robinson. Jilly loves you more than you will know. Mrs. Robinson, heaven holds a place for those who pray.
And we have returned on the Rada Grand Rapids Hoops Bus with Bob Rowe. And what were you going to say? This guy has been teasing me all week because as we've had our conversations over the last few weeks, he's like, are you going to be wearing a vest tonight?
No, I just wanted to know because I thought that one of us should carry on the tradition of the vest on Grand Alley. So here I am.
So you wore a vest.
Yes, my vest.
It's like Kara said, if I see you right one more vest, you're wearing too many vests.
I like the vest.
You like the vest?
Well, thank you. Thank you.
Well, then take me over there and we'll get it. Okay. You have a new album that's going to be out in
Heartbeat Records. Heartbeat Records out of London. It's going to be all over the place on the internet, in the store chains. It's already in several chains like John Rollins in the Kalamazoo area. Myers has had some of the older releases.
And we're out there. We're also going to have the new hit single of Does Our Second Guest Have a Pulse? That's going to be his next thing. You've been real talkative today. How are you?
Very good. Thank you very much. I'm
having a ball. Well, you are. You're on a hoops bus. Okay. Anyway, this has been an enormous undertaking. I think next week we return to the studio, all because of the staff. They're like, we aren't doing any more road shows. But we have a ton of people to thank here. Peter Varga, the interim executive director at Grada. We have Bob Frazier. You can start sneaking this.
Start sneaking it in. Yeah, we'll I was just going to say, you really ought to do a show from the inside of a tornado. This one was almost that.
That'll come out in May for our next sweep. You want to sneak the music in? Let's see. Okay. We're going to do As Time Goes By. We also want to thank Bob Frazier, transportation manager, Rhonda Frazier, the ever-loving marketing coordinator, and of course, Dave Groovy, Norm Devine of the Hoops, and our driver, Jim Archie. And what about this crew? Hang it in there. This is Greg Struss reminding you to tune in to News 3 at 5, 6, and 11, and we will see you next week. Goodbye.
Okay, everybody, here we go.
Oh, you must remember this. A kiss is still a kiss, and a sigh is still a sigh, and the fundamental things apply as time goes by.
Definitely works better in a vest.
And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you, that no one can deny.
I think we have the backup here.
No matter what the future brings,
okay, boss.
As time goes by.
All right, here we go. Moonlight and love songs.
Moonlight and love songs are never out of date. Hearts filled with passion, jealousy, and hate. Woman needs man. Man must have his mate that no one can deny. Still the same old story, a fight for love and glory, a case of do or die.
Okay, boss.
And the world will always welcome lovers as time goes by.
Yeah.
That's a take.
It's fast, it's fun, and it's legal. Find out every Saturday right here on Channel 3.